Hello everyone! In today's video, I'll be demonstrating what is probably our most popular software feature, OSP or Onboard Signal Processing option for the GP-Probe DIN L1 interference detector. The option enables the detector to operate completely standalone without internet or GP Cloud connectivity. Well, detecting jamming is not a big deal, so let's check how the device handles spoofing detection. For this experiment, I will be using our GPS simulator. You see our typical setup. A software-defined radio from Atos Research, reference receiver and some RF accessories. It looks simple, but this kit and our software allow us to generate even coherent spoofing scenarios. This software is known as GP Simulator. I will not go into details and explain how to configure this software. You will find a lot of videos about that on our channel. We will start with the most challenging type of spoofing, synchronous or coherent with minor power. This type of spoofing is hardest to detect. Let me remind you what synchronous spoofing is. At the start of attack, a signal identical to the real one is generated, matching all parameters. Coordinates, Doppler, pseudo ranges, and data streams. A GNSS receiver under this kind of spoofing instantly switches to the fake signal. After that, the coordinates or time can be gradually and imperceptibly manipulated. Detecting this type of spoofing, especially at the initial stage, is indeed challenging. On the right, you see the built-in web panel of our detector displaying real-time measurements. On the left, we have our GPS signal generator. Okay, let's start with a low power level at minus 140 dBm and click start. Now for a coherent spoofing start, we need to wait for the beginning of the GPS frame of the original signals. This will take some time. Meanwhile, let's look at the real-time measurements graphs we see on the web panel. We have the spectrum waterfall, power spectrum, anomaly probability graph with event detection threshold, peak power, horizontal position accuracy, PPF signal phase difference measurements, average signal to noise ratio for each system, the number of satellites, average residuals, and finally parameters for each satellite. Okay, the generator has started. And look, anomaly has been detected instantly. Notice that there is nothing visible on the spectrum. The fake signal is below the noise level. This means that a simple spectrum monitoring is completely ineffective for detecting GNSS spoofing. In the anomaly chart, we see 100%. The peak power graph shows obviously nothing. But on the signal-to-noise ratio chart, we see a jump from 30 to a little over 40 dB. And this is how a coherent attack works. The receiver instantly switched to the fake signal. Now let's try to shift the coordinates 1000 meters to the north. And nice, we see the position errors gradually increasing. Let's wait until the shift is complete. Great, the coordinates have shifted exactly 1 kilometer, just like we set on the spoofer. We successfully detected sophisticated coherent attack, without delay, pretty close to instantaneous. Let's move on. I'm switching to non-coherent spoofing and simulate a past time, let's say a year ago. Then we are downloading the almanac and ephemerids for the selected time. Let's keep the same power level and click start. The generator started immediately since it's not a synchronous attack. And what do we see here? Actually, we see nothing. No signal fluctuation or degradation in signal-to-noise ratio. And the reason is obvious. To conduct a successful non-coherent attack, we first need to block the reception of the original signals. For this, we can increase the spoofer's power or use a jammer. Even though the fake signal is weak, and didn't cause any visible anomalies, we can still notice a slight increase in the anomaly probability. Let's increase the power by 10 dB. Now the signal is clearly visible in the spectrum. Peak power exceeded the defined threshold and the anomaly detector has finally triggered to 100%. As you can see on the signal-to-noise ratio graph, there are some minor signal fluctuations. On the satellite bar chart, we see that the receiver is perceiving a mix of real and fake signals. The anomaly detection is stable at 100% and it's awesome. Let's try to block the reception of the original signals by increasing the output power by another 30 dB. Well, on the spectrum waterfall we observe a powerful signal. The peak power is huge. Nevertheless, we see that the built-in receiver has excellent interference resistance and still tracks the original signals. Let's increase the power by another 10 dB, and actually that's the maximum power level available for our setup. But even now, the power is insufficient. The receiver is still tracking the original signals. Well, the experiment was successful, spoofing has been detected. Now let's turn off the generator. You see, the peak power has dropped to noise level. Let's see how quickly the receiver recovers. Cool, it took about 40 seconds to restore tracking of the true signals. We see normal status on the display again, and all parameters look good. Let's check what information was recorded about the generated spoofing on the detected events page. Here we see two events, one with anomaly status, which was a coherent attack, and one with interference status. For each event, we can see the start and stop time, power spectrum with cursor measurements, central frequency, peak power, spectrum bits, and more. Well, we successfully detected non-coherent and even sophisticated coherent GPS spoofing with onboard signal processing option. This is a fantastic result for embedded algorithms in such a compact device. Given the broad built integration capabilities, this makes this device a truly powerful weapon against GNSS interference. Anyone interested in watching this live to test your own attack scenarios, book an online demo with me on our website. Thank you for watching and don't forget to like and subscribe for more updates.